Welcome to the video tutorial on installing macOS on Hyper-V Hypervisor. Let's get started. Launch Hyper-V and create a new virtual machine. Name your new virtual machine. Select Generation 2. This won't work with a Generation 1. I recommend that you set the memory to 8 GB. Click Connection drop-down and select Default Switch. I created a new folder and stored the virtual hard drive of the macOS virtual machine. Select Install an operating system later. The virtual machine has been created and here are some settings to run the macOS operating system. Adjust the following, under Security uncheck Enable Secure Boot. Disable checkpoints otherwise you will have issues later in your Hyper-V use. Under Integration Services select All Options. To boot the macOS virtual machine, there needs to be a folder called EFI. So you access the link in the description and download the virtual hard drive called uefi.vhdx. After downloading, copy and paste it to the virtual hard drive folder of the macOS virtual machine. You access the virtual hard drive named uefi.vhdx. Then you download the macOS recovery folder I put in the description. In this folder is the basesystem.dmg file. Copy this folder and paste it into the uefi.vhdx virtual hard drive. Right-click on the mounted UEFI drive and click Eject. Launch Hyper-V and add the UEFI virtual hard drive to the virtual machine just created in the previous step. Under SCSI controller select hard drive and click Add. Click Browse under Virtual Hard Disk. Find and select the UEFI.vhdx. The macOS virtual machine has two hard drives, one for booting and another for installation. Under Firmware adjust the boot order so the UEFI.vhdx hard drive is first and the other hard drive is second. Move the network to the end of the list. Your virtual machine is ready to install macOS. Right-click on the macOS virtual machine and click Connect. A window will open at which point you should click Start. You will see the Open Core boot menu and you begin installing macOS. During startup it may appear to freeze at an early boot but it will continue. Once the recovery loads Open Disk Utility. Select the MSFT Virtual Disk Media and format it as APFS with whatever name you want for the partition. Once formatted, exit Disk Utility. This installation will take some time. Eventually the installation will complete and you will be greeted with the initial personalization setup screens of your new macOS Hyper-V. Above are the steps to install macOS on Hyper-V Hypervisor on a Windows 11 computer. Thank you for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck!